Hello, lacrosse friends. Welcome to the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships. A critical match here in the green division between Ireland and Israel from the stunningly beautiful Village Pavilion here on the Onondaga Nation. Built in just 5 months, from what I've been told. A stunning performance. It's unbelievable. I'm not sure how much you get a sense of how beautiful this building is. It is pretty packed. People standing along the boards. The seats all full to see this Ireland-Israel match. Ireland 2-0. Israel is 1-1.
Oh, we lost?
The other teams in the division finished playing. This will decide. This game goes a long way to deciding what happens in the crossover games to see who has a chance to get to the semifinals and try to sneak up into the middle round. I'm Stephen Stamp bringing you this broadcast of the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships. Cole McCormick, Sonny Campbell, a little fist bump at mid-floor. As we get ready to get underway, you notice as we look at the face-off, the sticks being forced to be well apart, the officials really clamping down on it, at least over at the Onondaga Arena, which is where I've been calling most of the games in this event. They kind of sneak the sticks in a little late. McCormick gets pretty tight, and they actually do make him back up. But McCormick still gets his stick clamped down hard, taps it away, but he's run over. And the ball's knocked free. Ryan Doran hitting him, and the Irish come up with the ball. Andrew McBride, the captain, and the veteran Calgary Roughnecks defender knocked away. The ball knocked away from him by Cole McCormick. Kyle Bergman gets in, squeezes it back between him. Great shift by Cole McCormick. Throws a big pick and heads off the floor. Dan Deckelbaum started to head down the alley. It was closed off by Ryan Doran. Israel set up. Hopper is going to pass it over to the far side. Zach Paul, late addition to the lineup, hands it off. Hopper to Bergman. He gets a pick from Chad Culp, runs over to his offside. Hopper's lost his helmet. He's going to pick it up and run back to the bench. Illegal screen against the Irish. Israel. After they picked up that ball, they were trying to spring someone for a breakout. They got called for it.
Number one, Michael Cragen.
Israel will have the ball. And another possession, a fresh 30, as we're about a minute into the first game.
Between the pipes for Israel, number 31, Zachary Higgins.
Bergman rolls across the top. He's flattened by Sean Gibson. Sean Gibson recently playing his 50th international tournament game for Ireland. What an accomplishment for the young man. Penalty coming to Ireland. Gibson's done a whole lot to abet the growth of lacrosse in Ireland. There's a shot at the buzzer of the shot clock. Goes wide. But Israel will go to the power play. Chad Culp has to tie up his shoelaces. Oh, it's a double minor. Two slashing penalties back to back for Mike Shea. Big advantage for Israel here early in the game.
Slashing.
Deckelbaum will start with the ball up top. He's got Culp.
Possession remains with Israel.
And Bergman on this side with him. Sorry, it's actually Dan Deckelbaum down on the crease. On the far side, Hopper along with Noah Miller, the other righty. Still some conversation between the officials and Irish coach Jeff Dowling, who's... But now Ireland questioning whether a player was on the game sheet. We can hear Chad Culp telling his coach Brad MacArthur. Culp, a native of Arthur, Ontario, a player with the
4 minutes.
Buffalo Bandits in the National Lacrosse League and the Peterborough Lakers. Brad MacArthur down on the Israeli bench looking concerned about whether this player is on the game sheet. The officials checking. Dowling still questioning. The official said something to Dowling, the Irish coach, that he thinks should assuage him. He didn't necessarily seem assuaged, but play will continue as Israel goes to the power play. Miller up to Deckelbaum. He shoots. That's wide. Goes onto the backside of the mesh. Big hit by McBride on Hopper, who's trying to pick it up. The Irish come out with it. Deckelbaum forechecking. They've only got a couple seconds. They only got a few seconds to get over the line. They're going to make it. Gillis gets across. Silberlicht on him, pressuring. A couple of whacks to the hand. Nice job by Gillis to protect the ball. The Irish with 4 seconds on the shot clock, getting a couple of players off to get defenders on the floor. The shot goes wide.
Possession, Israel.
Israel will take over. MacArthur, the coach of the Barrie Blizzards, the Creators Cup champions as winners of the Canadian Lacrosse League this year. It's assisted by Jason Crosby, also assists him with the Junior B Clarington Greengales, another very successful franchise. Expect an up-tempo game from this Irish club, Israeli club. Chad Culp moving in, shoots, scores. Nice shot by Noah Miller, skipping it off the turf. Bit of an adjustment for the guys going from one arena to the other as the turf over in the Onondaga Village Arena is quite spongy, quite soft. This one, turf here, a little flatter, a little livelier. So you've got to, for the goalies and the shooters, you've got to get Israel used to.
Israel goal to number 41, Noah Miller.
Noah Miller.
Assisted by number 19.
Getting the goal, Chad Culp with the assist. Just the two of them is Culp. Just the one assist as Culp started out, number 19.
Ireland's
started with that ball, and it's 1-0 now. Israel goes on to the second power play. Seth Mahler will take the ball, gives it up to Culp, and heads to the bench as Hopper comes out. One more Israeli coming to join them. It'll be Noah Miller, the man who just scored. Culp behind the back, gets it back. Now he's going to go to Miller. No, he's going to shoot. Saved by Mike Cregan, who's had an excellent tournament so far. Culp up top, gives it back to Deckelbaum, who steps and shoots kind of mid-stride, trying to catch Cregan off guard, but he stopped it. Culp with the big hit into the boards. Tyler Roach doing a great job hanging onto it. Time running out to get across the line, so he just whips it down the floor. Oh, it comes straight out! What a chance for Gillis.
Higgins with a
sorry, save. That was Drew Snyder, number 92, with the scoring opportunity. Is that Ben Snyder, as that ball just bounced straight out to him. A funny hop off the boards. The Israelis got a bit of a break, but a nice save by Zach Higgins, another goalie in this division who's been outstanding through the series. There's a low shot, but landing in the crease was Hopper. It'll be Irish ball. 52 seconds left in the power play. Stephen Keel gets it across the line. He's trapped, can't go back over center. He's pinned, the ball's out. Nobody saw it, Harry Fried picks it up, Israeli ball. Harry Fried has to wait. Fried had a few breakaways in the Israelis' first game of this tournament and wasn't able to bury. Noah Miller comes back out. They've still got 25 seconds on the power play, 17 on the shot clock. Bergman has the ball and is double teamed. Takes a couple of slashes. Gets it across to Miller, who shoots. Saved by Cregan. It comes right out to Culp. He's going to let it rip as well. Off the post. Cregan. Israel gets it back. 10 seconds on the penalty. Noah Miller holding on to it. Up to Culp. Could be a dangerous time to shoot if it comes out like it does. But the penalty expires as Culp tracks it down.
Full strength.
So Shea's going to come and run from behind. Oh, if he'd been a half second later, he might have been able to run away with a break there. But Bergman picks up the ball off the backboards. 18 to shoot, lots of time for Israel. Noah Miller getting pushed out hard. There's a shot from the far side by Miller. Crease call as Bergman was still in the crease. Ireland will get it. They're back to full strength. They trail 1-0 just over 10 minutes to go here in the first period. I'm Stephen Stamp bringing you this WILC Green Division game from the Onondaga Village Pavilion. Stephen Keogh takes it, member of the Rochester Nighthawks. Won 3 straight Champions Cups with them. Oh, and a goal by Kevin Owens. What a great shot. Kevin Owens rolling across the top. Takes the pass from Keogh, and just tucks it home. Very nice play there as they roll through the off the pick. Owens on the run, goes back against the green, gets it past the foot of Zach Higgins. And we're tied 1-1 with 9:49 to go here in the first period. Beautiful facility here, but it's a bit cool this morning. The wind whips right through the open sides, and it is a little chilly here. Ben Snyder checked in the boards by Cole McCormick. Paul comes up with the ball.
Kevin Owens.
Zach Paul spins off a check. We have a moving pick on Israel. And Ireland will head up the floor. The ball being run by Mike Shea. Gillis takes it. Thought about coming to Owens, but goes over to Tyler Roach. Roach a defender with the Peterborough Junior Lakers. But playing offense here and gets an assist. Gillis with a beauty. A nice three-man game. Gillis taking the pass. Gillis takes the pass from Wichman. Second assist going to Tyler Roach. And it is 2-1 in favor of Ireland. Again, with Ireland at 2-0, they're in very good shape for the next round. The Israelis need to win this game if they want to move on to the crossovers. McCormick,
assisted on the goal.
Oh, nice job to tap the ball back to Seth Mahler, who's sprinting down the outside. Shea stays with him. Now Snyder comes to help. Israel starts to get a couple of offensive guys out, so they're slowly setting things up. Culp in the middle. Deckelbaum loses the ball. Bergman loses the ball, that is. Miller picks it up. Gibson running back into position. Snyder out high. The Irish pushing the defense out. Bergman's shot off the shoulder. Ball wasn't the clock wasn't reset.
Ireland ball.
Israel loses the ball. And they're upset because that ball clearly went off the shoulder of Mike Cregan. It should have been an Israeli possession once again. Liebenthal picks the ball up. Leventhal running the floor. Now he'll head back. Zach Paul taking his time while his cohort gets out there. Chase Clark pushing his way into the middle, trying to fight through to the open space. Goes again as Paul is knocked to the ground. Gets a shot off, but it goes wide. Cregan can't reach it, but the Irish do recover. Nice wrap check attempt there, but they can't jar the ball loose. That was Zach Paul going after it. Kevin Owens takes the pass and sets up in the offensive zone for Ireland. Stephen Keogh gives it back to him. So that's to Tim O'Connor. Six on the shot clock. Keogh's going to let it fly. Glances off of Higgins, and Ireland gets a reset. And Coach Brad MacArthur of Israel is pointing out to the refs that they missed it at the other end, which is absolutely true. That one bounces off the backboard. It's lively boards here. We have a penalty coming.
Penalty coming up.
Too many men on Israel.
Israel penalty for the in-home designated in-home number 32, Daniel Leventhal. 2 minutes.
Referees explained to Brad MacArthur. He still has a point he wants to make. It's the media timeout as we're past the halfway point of the first quarter. It is 2-1 in favor of Ireland, and they will be going to the power play. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more of this WILC contest between Ireland and Israel. Okay, we are back. Took a quick break, but just wanted to share with you something. It's we can actually are located right over top of the benches, very close to the Israel bench, so we can hear the conversation sometimes. Brad MacArthur was saying he was very unhappy with the too many men call because he felt that his player was in the box. He was on the floor, but in the change box, and he thinks the one official missed it. And the referee he was talking to is talking to the other official while they're measuring the sticks. We do that. They do it at every break in the game. Grab two sticks at random, one from each team, and measure them to make sure they're within regulations. Do a drop test to make sure the ball isn't pinching. Everything's good to go. Zach Paul gets a stick back. Ireland goes to the power play, and Zach Higgins sprints back to his goal where he will try to fend off this Irish man advantage.
We might need some more sheets if you write that.
7:27 left in the first period. Israel 1, Ireland 2.
Owens with the ball up top. Moves it off to Gillis. He fakes a little and gives it to Owens. Ireland sticking on the outside for now. Owens has a bit of space. He's going to shoot just wide. Bounces back to him. He's going to try and track it down, but nice hustle by Flapen to knock the ball loose. Can't pick it up on his first try. Keel gets on him. Sorry, that's Gillis. And now Snyder gets in, knocks it loose. Flapen still working hard, battling for the ball. Israel getting their defenders off on the floor because Flapen is out number 3-1. And eventually Ireland does come up with the ball. They'll set back up, but the defenders didn't have to race, so Israel got nice fresh legs, except for Flapen, who ran all the way back and will continue. See if they try and take advantage of him after he had to sprint up the floor and back down. Stephen Keogh has it. Ireland's still getting their offensive set out. Keogh fakes the pass, now goes to the latecomer Owens. Passes across, it's low, can't be caught. Israel gets it, looking for the breakout. Harper will take the pass, but he's jumped by Stephen Keogh, flips around him and gets the ball. Nice, smart play by Keogh. Harper just couldn't fend him off, and Harper will go back and play defense. They hit the cutter in the middle. Gillis, his shot goes just wide. Wasn't sure if it had touched Higgins or the post, but no reset, so it must have been wide. Keogh up top, slow things down. They've got 9 seconds. Owens makes a pick. Shot goes wide. Keogh's going to track it down. It's going to actually be stopped by Gillis. Time will expire. He takes the shot. The ball goes in. The Irish fans are cheering wildly, but it was clearly in after the buzzer. No question. The Ireland fans are a little disappointed. I think they knew in their hearts, or they knew in their heads, that that ball was in after the buzzer, but in their hearts, they thought they had beaten the timer. Chad Culp will kill the rest of the penalty. Now the Israeli offense comes out. Zach Paul will join the group. Culp shoots. That one's blocked by a defender. It's picked up by Hopper, who gets a shot off. Misses, though, and Shea will go the other way.
Violation.
Clock buzzes inadvertently. Shea looking around, very aware, making sure there's nobody sneaking up on him. Gives it off to Tyler Roach. Roach, again, a defender usually. Showing some nice hands here in the offensive end.
5 minutes in the first period.
We'll give it up to Gillis.
One, Ireland two.
He and Keogh play catch. 8 seconds to shoot. Oh, Gillis almost gets the pass. It goes through the crease, touched by Higgins. So it'd be a fresh 30. Penalty coming to Israel again.
Penalty coming up.
It's going to be a slash on Jason Silberlicht. Silberlicht very politely asks why he's getting a penalty, what exactly he did. And the ref says, you slashed, go to the box. Ireland returns to the power play. Great opportunities for Ireland. They're going to want to take advantage of some of them.
Israel penalty for the assistant captain, number 77, Jacob Silberlicht. 2 minutes for slashing.
Referee saying he doesn't want to hear from Brad MacArthur. MacArthur making it quite clear he's not raising his voice. He's not swearing. He's just asking a question. Keogh with the shot goes off the boards into the back of the mesh. It's very interesting to be up here and hear the conversations between the coaches and officials. Flapen is running the floor again. McBride is out there to meet him. The offense coming to join Flapen. He's going to pull it back. Israel feeling like Ireland getting a big jump. Heading to the box for their changes, getting their defenders out early. Culp has the ball, 8 on the shot clock. He's going to drive to the net and score! A shorthanded marker. Chad Culp, known for his grittiness and feistiness, Shows he has some great hands too as he dipsy doodles through the Irish defense. Bears a shorthanded marker, and it's 2-2.
Israel goal scored by number 19, Chad Culp, the captain, assisted by number 11, Brian Hopper. That's Culp and Hopper.
Number 11, Brian Hopper, getting the assist after the restart. McCormick and Campbell lining up for the faceoff. Quite a battle. McCormick pulls it out, but McBride is there to scoop it up for Ireland. We're 2-2, the Irish go to the power play. O'Connor takes the ball. Owens. You may notice as you're looking at the back of these jerseys that, oh, there's Owens trying to get the pass in the middle. Tracked down, but the Irish jerseys have their names in Gaelic. There's a shot by Keogh. That was in time. It would have counted, Higgins, but the save by Higgins. Keogh knocks.
Crease violation.
Mahler into the crease and gives him a little tap in the back of the leg, the high leg, for good measure. 49 left on the power play, so plenty of time with a fresh shot clock. Owen's shot doesn't get through, but it falls right by Keogh. Picks it up, tries to get another one. The Irish get it back again. Gillis down to O'Connor. He'll come back up top. Nobody open in the middle or low. That pass gets away from O'Connor.
Higgins.
And over on the far side, Dan Kelly picks it up. Owens. That ball pass knocked down. Freed can't handle it. Had plenty of chance, but it just then they get on him, and Keogh gets it back. Tough break for the Israelis. And it turns into a big break for the Irish. Harry Freed couldn't pick the ball up. Stephen Keogh, number 28, buries it. And it's 3-2 for Ireland on a power play goal. Nice job by the Irish to knock the ball down, or by the Israelis to knock the ball down, but unfortunately for them, it bounced right to Stephen Keogh.
Stephen Keogh, unassisted.
Unassisted marker by Keogh as it just popped straight out to him. Freed trying to pick the ball up. It got banged around and rolled right to Keogh, who just a moment later fired it home. Flapen comes up with the ball. Three Irish get a shot at him. He's still up on his feet. Andrew McBride pushes him well outside and bangs him into the boards. Shows him a little taste of National Lacrosse League defense. McBride, the captain for Ireland, also the captain for the Calgary Roughnecks. Also the technical director of Alberta Lacrosse. Oh, what a goal by Zach Paul. I don't know that Cregan saw that one. 5 seconds of the shot clock, so Paul just stepped around a screen and let it rip over the shoulder of the defender down by the foot of Michael Cregan. And Zach Paul has tied things up at 3-3 with 2:23 to go here in the first quarter. Seems like a very long quarter.
Israel,
but we are still in the first quarter of this World Indoor Lacrosse Championships game between Israel and Ireland. Dalton Lundy, who plays Junior B with the Clarington Green Gales for Brad MacArthur and Jason Crosby, gets the ball off that faceoff. They go into the offensive zone. Harper. Chase Clark cutting to the middle. Bergman spins, shoots. Oh, off the post.
Cregan with a save.
Bergman chops down, but Gibson still able to come up with it. Pass too far ahead. But it's run overrun by Deckelbaum, and Sonny Campbell's able to pick it up. He'd missed it initially, but Deckelbaum missed it as he ran by. The Irish lined up with the ball. Tyler Roach with it. Ireland taking their time. Keogh up top, shoots through a screen. Higgins stops it. Flapen picks it up, runs around the crease, and passes to Deckelbaum. You hear the Israeli coaches, they want their guys to push the ball up the floor, try to get things going in transition, and then go into the set offense if it's there. If the transition isn't there, Culp will give it off to Deckelbaum. Miller just getting in there as the fifth attacker. He's going to get the pass. Nobody saw him till late, and he shoots, but it's stopped by Cregan. Zach Jordan just got out on him.
Possession.
Make a bit of a push check, which may have been enough to send him wide. You can hear the coaching going on these benches. You can see it in all the arenas, all these developing lacrosse countries with some tremendous coaching staffs in place who are working from game to game, shift to shift to help these teams get better. That shot, no over and back. Because it went off of the Israelis, Keel gets it. Stripped. Does a nice job to keep Adam Crystal from getting a breakaway. Crystal will be the first one down there, but O'Connor's on him. Tim O'Connor shoves Crystal into the board. Just going to be a push from behind. Israel gets the ball. And a fresh 30. Israel. Chad Culp starts with the ball in the corner. Watched by Andrew McBride. Those two familiar with each other from battles through the NLL. Moving pick as McBride is flattened. He takes a look around to see who it was and stepped in as though he was going to take a cross check at Hopper, who was the nearest Israel player. Ireland running the ball up the floor. Reversal by O'Connor. He's rammed into the boards and flaping from behind is going to get a penalty. Two minutes to Matthew Flapen. Can the officials having to deal with getting used to other referees from other countries, other languages? Everyone is communicating in English, but some are stronger than others. That will do it for the first quarter. There was less than a second left on the clock, so they'll just run the time. And we will start the second quarter with a power play for Ireland after Matthew Flapen takes the two-minute check from behind call. Not a flagrant call, but definitely a player along the boards ran into his back. We're going to take a quick break. I'm Stephen Stamp bringing you this WILC game from the Onondaga Village Pavilion.
Face-off X for Ireland, number 32, Kevin Owen. And for Israel, number 20, Cole McCormick.
Welcome back, lacrosse friends, to the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships. We start the second period with Ireland on a power play, and they'll get the ball after a face-off violation by Cole McCormick.
Ireland currently on the
Brian mound. Gillis with the ball along the boards, gives it down low to Kelly. Dan Kelly passes it back up to him, and Owens will get it on the far side to Keogh. Keogh mentioned earlier has three Champions Cup championships. He also won in 2013 and 14 the Man Cup with the Six Nations Chiefs. Makes the low pass to Kelly on the crease, but it doesn't connect. 3 seconds, he'll just let it rip. That goes off a defender. Nice job by Silberlich to get his stick in the way. And Israel kills off the first quarter of that penalty. Again, the Flapen checking from behind call. Dalton Lundy brings it up into the offensive zone. He'll just hang on to it. Now he bounces it over to Culp. He will stay out. I thought they were calling him to the bench, and they are. Brian Hopper will go out. Culp being unharassed as he stays up top, just inside the restraining line. Now a few pokes. Jordan gets him down to 1 second. Culp shoots, the follow through, whacking Jordan pretty good. Cregan makes the save on the long outside shot, and Ireland will trot up over the floor. Zach Jordan to Gillis, gives it to Keogh. Tim O'Connor doing some hard work down on the crease. Now he steps out to open a shooting lane. Keogh's shot turned aside by the foot of Zach Higgins. It'll be a fresh 30. Silver licked a little whack on Keogh. He whacks him back. The whistle hadn't gone, the buzzer had. So Silberlick kept playing and Keogh didn't like it. Kelly comes around, goes to Keogh, is gonna fire. Off the boards again. Ireland reaches in.
Crease violation.
But he stepped in the crease, so it's Israel ball.
Israel ball.
Lundy taking his time, heading up.
Israel returns.
Gets it over center in plenty of time. You have 10 seconds to get across the center line, for anyone not familiar with it. For the most part, the FIL rulebook of a given year is the rulebook from the National Lacrosse League from the year before. There's a shot by Brian Hopper on the run. Goes back against the grain and buries it past the foot of Michael Cregan. 4-3, Israel jumps ahead.
Israel goal scored by number 11, Brian Hopper, assisted by number 71, Zachary Paul. That's Paul.
Zach Paul gets the assist, number 71. And Cole McCormick wins the faceoff. Israel gets the ball right back. Kyle Bergman will move it up to Dan Deckelbaum. Noah Miller takes his pass. Israel with 17 on the shot clock as Hopper gets back on the floor. They're still changing personnel as Culp comes out. Miller throws it over to Deckelbaum, and Bergman takes it with his back right against the boards. Gets a pick from Culp, comes out high, scores! Great pick from Culp, and a shot from Noah Miller. Buries it into the top corner, it's 5-3.
Israel
McCormick and Campbell line up for the faceoff. 12-12 to go in the second quarter. 5-3 in favor of Israel. Israel gets another faceoff. They're starting to control the play off the faceoffs. Cole McCormick doing a great job. His main role is to get faceoff wins. That shot by Culp bounces off a defender and comes back out. Chase Clark picks it up. He cuts to the middle. Ball comes around the outside. Paul gets a big whack from Shea. Ball pops out. Hopper shoots. Cregan stops it. Oh, a big hit up on Tim O'Connor by Leventhal. None of the refs notices it. It's well away from the play. Sorry about that adventure in camera land. We just had a little tilt there. Nice job saving it by our crew chief. And we are back on level ground as Brian Harper takes the ball. Kevin Harper. Penalty coming to Ireland. Zach Higgins sprints to the bench for the extra attacker. 12 seconds for Israel to take advantage as Noah Miller gets on the floor and Culp throws it over to the far side. Bergman back up to Culp, four to shoot. He's gonna slip by, cuts through, gets the shot off. Cregan with the save. Deckelbaum gets the ball back, or Bergman gets the ball back. Miller will shoot, save again, and this time the rebound swallowed up by Cregan. Israel will go to the power play with a 5-3 lead and tons of momentum on their side.
What happened? What? Is it her bouncing around?
It's bounced.
The camera tilting? tripod.
She didn't do it. It wasn't her fault.
Chad Culp will start with the ball
Ireland's
on the Israel power play.
The number 92.
Deckelbaum gives it back to him. Bergman's down low. They come over to Miller.
Schneider, 2 minutes for illegal body.
Bergman rolls out, turns and shoots. Oh, and it hits Tyler Roach right in the face. Israel tucks the ball home well after the whistle had played, and they call immediately for the trainers. Ireland trainer Terry McHugh makes his way out to the floor to give Roach some support. 1:44 left in the penalty taken by Ben Snyder. Israel leads 5-3, and the Irish players are heading over to their bench. The penalty kill Shavichak as Roach is down and in clear discomfort. He's on his hands and knees now. As you can see, Michael Cregan staying there. Certainly hope that he's okay. Roach still down. Andrew McBride having a chat with the referees. Pointing over at the Israeli bench. Trying to make sure the Israelis don't get too much influence on the officials' crew. Andrew McBride, a wily veteran. McBride talking to them, and the referee asks the Israeli players to move away from the bench. Referee saying it's his fault that he didn't call them over earlier. Tyler Roach is up.
Ireland's number 20, Tyler Roach.
Doesn't appear to have anything extraordinarily out of place. The nose still intact.
Possession Israel.
Clearly shaken up a bit. He's going to slip out the far side of the bench and head around out of the way of the rest of the team for some treatment. Culp behind the back. Hard shot, but stopped by Cregan. Little spin move by Shea. The Israel wanted a back in call, and it was very close as he spun, but O'Shea not called for it. Sorry, it says O'Shea on the back of his jersey. As mentioned before, the Irish players having the Gaelic names in. Gillis with McGillach or so on the back of his shirt. O'Donoghue.
Me neither.
Sorry, Drew Wichman. Pulling his way through, kills the full 30. And Israel will come back up, still on the power play for another minute five, as we're just past 5 minutes into the second quarter of this Green Division game from the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships in the Onondaga Nation Pavilion. Pass across to Hopper. He had to drop his stick head to catch the pass, or he would have buried that one. But Cregan had time after Bergman's pass was a little bit too low. Culp's up top, 21 seconds on the shot clock. Stick knocked right over his hands by Andrew McBride. They come over to Miller. He steps and shoots wide. Culp tracks it down. It skips away from him. 7 seconds left on the shot clock as Bergman gets it back. Shot by Deckelbaum. What a goal by Brian Hopper. The rebound bounces right out to him, and Brian Hopper buries it off the rebound from Deckelbaum. 6-3. Israel now doubling up Ireland with that power play goal.
Goal scorer for Israel's number 11, Brian Hopper. Unassisted.
Just over 9 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Germany with 1 win and 1 loss in the tournament so far. Israel with a win and a loss. Ireland at 2-0. Gotta expect that Germany will beat Switzerland later in the day. Oh, sorry, that's the other division. There's a shot and a save by Cregan in the crease.
Crease violation.
Serbia, actually, the other team in the division. They are 0-2. So if Germany wins that one, and Israel were to win this, we'd have a three-way tie. It would go to goals plus and for and against goal differential among the three teams to decide who would go on. Big hit. Gillis loses the ball, gets it back. Lundy's still on him. Gets away, gets a shot, scores! What a play by Gillis. A solo effort to get away from the tight checking of Dalton Lundy and then shakes free of him. Slides up top and rips it down low.
Goal for Ireland's number 88, Brian Gillis, unassisted.
Scoring really picked up in this game. The first quarter, just a goal apiece. And then lots of goals coming here in the second. Actually, no, it's a little later, sorry. I'm looking at the wrong line on my sheet. Ireland pulls back within two. They make it 6-4. If Serbia were to beat Germany this afternoon, then Ireland is in regardless of what happens in this game. They go to the crossovers, but they can't count on that. Serbia has played very well, been quite competitive. Now we're going to have a moving pick against Ireland. The second time we've seen the Irish called for a moving pick. Hopper and McBride getting into it. Hopper's wide open now. Ireland had lost track of him, but Israel didn't see him available over on the near side. Now he gets the ball, comes in, gets a pick by Zach Paul. It's a moving pick as he flattened the Irish player in front of him.
Ireland.
Israel trying to keep Mike Shea out from the net. He'll pass it back to Keogh, and Ireland sets up on offense. Next stoppage and play, we'll see the media timeout. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Gillis, open on this side, starts to slip down back door. Nice job though by Harper to keep Ireland from getting a shot, and then another Israel defender, Harry Fried, steps in, blocks the shot, and that's gonna be the media timeout. 7:16 to go here in the second quarter. Israel with a 6-4 lead in this World Indoor Lacrosse Championships game. I'm Stephen Stamp, and I'll be right back with more of the game after a quick break.
Sorry, I thought you were, that was dividing the periods.
No, I couldn't read, so
oh, okay. You're just separating.
I think
okay.
It was here, I'm not really sure.
I just won't talk about it anymore.
My assistant sucks, so.
You're doing great. You're writing a bit big, spacing it out, but you know.
It's okay. It's we'll hard use to say one out for, that I can tell your name.
We'll use one for the first half.
There we go.
Yeah, they said it was how I said after about.
Yeah, it's your OU.
Which we, you know what's funny? Because I was like, no, we don't. They say, you say, oh, no, we don't. No, no. And then I listened to it a bunch again. Yeah. You dancing or waving?
Chad Culp will start with the ball for Israel up top. They are on the power play. The penalty to Ben Snyder, giving them the edge.
Penalty to number 92, Ben Snyder, during the timeout. Deemed to have 2 minutes for illegal equipment.
It's an illegal equipment call from the Czech of the sticks during the break there. Ball did not pop out sufficiently of his stick. A little over pinch. And he will serve 2 minutes or less. Israel will try and extend their lead from the 6-4 they now currently enjoy. Gillis. Along the boards. Keogh taking his time. 15 to shoot. Flapen poking him. A little slashing. Big slash on the head, and he's going to get a penalty for that one as he brought the stick down on the helmet of Keogh. And that will do it once Israel picks up the ball for their penalty. And you can hear Brad MacArthur telling Flapen, just cross-check. You don't have to slash. Cross-check. Got away with about three slashes that were fairly minor, but then the stick gets up high, comes down onto the helmet of Stephen Keogh, and we're 4-on-4 for the next minute and 8 seconds.
Israel,
Tyler Roach is okay and back from getting some treatment. He'll join this 4-on-4 situation. Dalton Lundy way out to the restraining line to check. Poke check on Gillis, who tries to run by him. Shoots, just misses the net off the boards. Dalton Lundy picks it up. He's going to run ahead. Pass down onto the crease. Silberlicht with the shot. Stopped by Cregan. And Andrew McBride will pass the ball ahead. McBride takes it back. He's going to stay up for an offensive shift. No, he's not. He's going to pass it off to Gillis. And head to the bench. Owens takes it up top. Gillis has some space. Steps around. Deckelbaum is coming out to him and goes for the screenshot. You're going to say over and back call.
Israel possession.
Israel starting the ball. Hopper was open, but play wasn't blown in yet. So Ireland had a chance to pick him up. Mike Shea gets on him. 5 seconds in the penalty to Ireland. So Israel's going to go to the kill here.
Ireland returns the full.
As the Irish get a fifth player on, McBride coming off the bench. The captain going after Culp. Culp just steps back away from him. 10 seconds on the shot clock. 40 on the penalty to Matthew Flapen. Hopper knocked down. Shot clock expires. The Irish running. McBride all alone. Got plenty of time. Save by Higgins. Goes off the foot of McBride, up off the glass, and bounces back. Shea gets it. Jordan picks up the ball. Fresh 30 for the Irish, and they'll get the offense out there on the power play for another 14 seconds. We'll see what they're able to create or if they're just going to wait. You want to be careful about taking a shot late in the penalty in case a rebound or ricochet comes out to the man coming out of the box. Keogh trying to get the shot off. Israel may be lucky they didn't get a penalty there as Zach Paul's stick
Israel
jostled the helmet on the head of Stephen Keogh. Ball pops loose off the backboards. Keogh tries to pick it up. Hopper comes down harder on his stick. Shot clock expires. It's Israeli possession. 4:10 to go here in the second quarter. Miller takes the pass. Was going to go back to Paul, but a nice job by McBride to get into the passing lane. It was actually Connor Dockery that got in the passing lane. Got to give him credit for that. Tyler Roach takes a penalty on Dan Deckelbaum. The ball bounces out to Israel, so Bergman's got a chance to get a shot. Shoots wide. Shot clock will expire. Actually, it's going to be picked up by the Irish first. Holding call to Tyler Roach as he got beaten, latched on.
Penalty to Ireland's number 20, Tyler Roach. 2 minutes for holding. That's Roach. 2 minutes for holding.
Couple of goals each so far for Brian Hopper and Noah Miller for Israel. They're going to see if they can add to the 6-4 lead on the power play. Bergman takes a slash and goes down, but gets back up. Shot by Deckelbaum. His follow-through hits Gibson. They're going to say no over and back because it went off of an Irish player. So Chad Culp has lots of time. A little trouble picking it up. 4 seconds to shoot. Kulpstra stopped by Cregan, rolls out, but it's picked up. Gibson the long lead pass to McBride, but it's too far. Higgins all the way in the corner. McBride doesn't slow down, runs into Higgins. Silberlich goes after him. They get the shot. What a save by Zach Higgins. Ireland gets the shot, but Higgins dives back into his net. And then Silberlich takes another shot at Andrew McBride. You can see that one coming a mile away after McBride ran into Higgins. McBride did a good job of slowing down, so he didn't take a charging call. Higgins, though, is wanting to be protected, talking to the officials. And the Irish, Israel's wide open to the other end, but Bergman lands in the crease. Ireland gets the ball.
Possession, Ireland.
The action fast and furious here now. McBride wanted a penalty at the other end after Silberlich jumped on top of him and cross-checked him. Really nothing wrong with what McBride did officially, legally, as per the rules, but in the spirit of the game, opponents will go after you if you run into the goalie. And by tying Higgins up, McBride almost created a goal for Ireland, but what a response by Higgins to sprint back to the net. Stephen Keogh's shot goes wide. It's a break for Matthew Flate, but Ben Snyder gets back to take away the opportunity. And the Israelis will set up, and Bergman comes into the net, spins back out. He wants to shoot, fakes, goes low. Snyder knocks it loose. McBride picks it up. 2:04 to go in the second period. 6-4 the score for Israel. They get the ball. Silberlich sprinting. He is quick. What a save by Michael Cregan. Silberlich in the Israeli army. Very fit and fast. Mike Shane's got the ball with 1:45 to go. Just 3 seconds in the Irish penalty to Tyler Roach. Gillis has it. Roach steps out of the box. And we'll go to join the offense. He looked to the bench. The ref stole it. The coach has told him, go on out. Clancy Almas helping out in the Irish bench. Another Canadian coach. Moving pick by Ireland.
Israel.
Going to say that Israel wants a delay of game penalty, and they will get it. Not a good decision by Kevin Owens to delay the ability of the Israelis to pick up the ball and run. Didn't roll the ball away, just interfered with Israel's ability to pick it up and go start play. FIL following the lead of the National Lacrosse League, saying you've got to put the ball down. And we'll have quick possessions, quick restarts. Israel on the power play.
2 minutes
for the last part of the second period here. Ball gets away from McBride. Deckelbaum gets it to Bergman. He shoots. Thought about going to Hopper on the far side of the crease. McBride gets it and gets out of trouble. Gets it ahead to Roach, but it pops off his stick, and Deckelbaum will pick up the ball. McBride is in a bit of discomfort after he was run down. Israel will set up with the final minute of play having been reached. The shot stopped by Cregan off the stick of Hopper. He bats it in. They say no goal, crease.
Crease violation.
Israel's not sure why. Timeout. Clear indication by the official, no goal, crease violation. Brad MacArthur and Jason Crosby asking why. The ball was in the crease. Hopper reached in and batted in. Chad Culpa saying, saying you can do that. There's going to be a roughing call. Two roughing calls, Deckelbaum and Shea. Deckelbaum actually gets the slash, and Shea gets the roughing. 1:24 still to go in the penalty that Kevin Owens took. And Brad MacArthur wants an explanation of the crease rule. The officials stop to chat about it with each other first. Now he comes over.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Israeli goal is good. Number 11, Brian Hopper, scoring for Israel. Penalty to Ireland's number 56, 2 minutes for roughing.
5-on-4. Israel's going to want a timeout when they get possession. They were thinking about taking one, actually, right there to set up. They decided to wait for possession.
And Taylor Israeli penalty.
Seth Mahler running after Andrew Wichman.
Has he been here too?
Wichman avoiding Mahler. Sidestepping along the boards. Mahler tries to cross-check him, but he gets away. 15 on the shot clock. 36 in the period. In the half, indeed. Wichman boarding Mahler off with one hand. Banged into the boards. 5 seconds to shoot. He's going to come out and get a shot off. Almost scores as it bounces off the foot of Zach Higgins. Wichman was just trying to get a reset with the shot on net and almost got a goal. Israel will take the timeout.
Timeout.
5-on-4 power play here. With 20.1 seconds to go in the second quarter, the score 6-4 in favor of Israel.
Second period, Israel 6, Ireland 4.
Salt in the wound. Chase Clark starting with the ball, 16 seconds to go. Gives to Hopper, gets it back, gives it back again. Now they get Culp involved. He goes behind the net. Hopper's pass is grabbed by Bergman, goes up high, rolls into the crease. McBride chops down on it. The second period will end. McBride gives Hopper a shove. The score 6-4 for Israel over Ireland after 30 minutes of play. Chase Clark getting involved in the power play there. I'm joined by his cousin, Rebecca Zisch, up on the platform here. We're calling the game. She's helping out, keeping track of the statistics. Made the trip with her mother, her grandmother, her aunt. Everyone here to follow Chase as he tries to help Israel climb as high as possible on the world lacrosse ladder. We're going to take a break for the intermission. We'll be back with the third quarter of Ireland versus Israel from the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships in the Onondaga Nation.
It's actually really quite cold up here.
Do you need a jacket?
No, I'll be okay. Cold?
Yeah, you can wear my jacket.
Really? Okay, thanks. I'm usually not cold.
Wow, it's because the air's coming in from here.
Yeah,
and it's sort of like,
yeah. Oh, that helps.
Yeah.
Not my wrists, but it helps the rest of us.
If I go down, they might not let me back up.
Yes, we're going to be here in Oh, I'm exactly.
So, like, when the phone was ringing, I think it was during...
So, if Israel beats Ireland, they rank number one.
It depends. Because if Germany beats Serbia, their team well is right.
So it'd be goal differential?
It'd be goal differential. So Germany beat Israel by one.
One.
Israel beats Serbia by
three. Two, three. Maybe it was four or five. Oh, this one's not either.
belt, too.
It's my Wyoming belt.
It's kind of distracting at times.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. This is going to be like talking and be like, what was that?
I know, my little shit. This is a small belt buckle, too.
Well, like, oh.
So, yeah.
Colorado is probably
like,
right after.
I'm, yeah.
Ontario is massive.
Yeah, how did,
it's how my family thinks about me. They don't find me.
Apparently not.
They're just not looking.
Really? You're on the right back, though.
No, Miss Gordon.
My college.
I think your grandma almost got in a fight. She's chirping somebody in the Ireland section.
Yeah.
Your mom's like,
it would not surprise me at all if we got thrown out of the game. She's spicy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Team Ireland. Ladies and gentlemen, Team Israel.
They don't see you.
If I knew Hebrew, I would chant something in Hebrew for them.
What kind of
shit are you? I'm a terrible
kid. I'm not.
I'm a modernized Jew. Modernized and converted. Oh boy.
Modernized and what?
Converted.
Oh. Converted to what?
Just like, just converted.
Oh really?
Yeah.
What made you do that?
My faith. So I'm heritage Jewish,
yeah.
And religious.
I was raised Catholic.
Were you?
Yeah.
Are you anti-religion now?
I'm recovering.
Relationship and not religion.
Yeah.
So I'm abandoning you guys for the fourth quarter. I'm abandoning you for the fourth quarter.
Why?
I gotta go cheer it on. It's my last game.
Oh, I see how you are. Use me and abuse me.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know, I know.
That's
how you
what
are.
I'm here for.
Yeah.
Okay. Then she leaves.
And then I just walk away.
Welcome back, lacrosse friends, to the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships. I'm Stephen Stamp, bringing you this game between Ireland and Israel. Just quick recap, Ireland 2-0 can assure themselves of a spot in the crossover games with a win. Israel at 1-1, they win. It could create a three-way tie, depending on what happens between Germany and Serbia. If the Germans win, Israel definitely needs a win here. If Serbia wins, we could actually have a three-way tie for second. If Ireland were to win this game and Serbia were to win the later game,
yeah, and you're not gonna be
we would have Israel,
welcome back to the third period.
Serbia, and Germany would all be 1-2. And then we'd be looking at a tiebreaker by goal differential between those three teams for the second spot. Third 32 seconds remaining in the penalty to Kevin Owens for delay of game. McCormick and Campbell battling for the faceoff. Keogh tries to pull it out. Bergman going after it. Everyone hits the floor. They go after it, and McCormick is going to grab. No, they're going to be a call first.
Possession
Irish
call.
Possession.
Ireland.
Didn't see what the call was for, but Ireland will get the ball. The penalty clock is not counting down. The Irish bench is yelling because nothing. Now it starts. There should be 21 seconds off it. There should only be 11 seconds left in the penalty. The penalty clock just didn't start counting down. Now he's going to be released as the official did become aware of it. So Ireland back to full strength. Now a penalty coming to Ireland.
Penalty coming up.
Save. We'll see what this call is. Too many men on Ireland. I don't understand why they're calling too many men. They're saying illegal substitution, which is the same as too many men on the floor.
Ireland penalty to the designated in-home number 16, Michael Kennedy. 2 minutes for delay of game.
Chad Culp having a chat with the officials. Still an Irish player and an Israeli player in there for matching penalties earlier at the end of the, or in the second quarter. Andrew McBride asking the officials to check the score sheet. The Irish player did come out, and it looked like the official was waving him out when the time expired, when it should have expired, because again, the penalty clock didn't start running. The scorer explained it to him. Ireland still getting the too many men penalty, though. So Israel will go to the power play, leading 6-4, 50 seconds into the third period. It's taken a while to get through these 50 seconds. Bit of a long game, actually. Culp to Bergman. Chase Clark down low on the crease. Bergman to Culp. Shot right into the chest of Cregan. Hopper tries to bat that one out. We got clarification about the in the crease rule from earlier. Big hit by Roach, and he's going to get a penalty. The two officials near him didn't have their hands up for it, but it's the far official seems to be the lead man who saw it. Chad Culp having a chat with Irish coach Jeff Dowling. It'll be 5-on-3. Chase Clark comes off and Bergman goes out. Deckelbaum being beckoned by the coach Jason Crosby. They're going to send Silverlick out. Silverlick will go out and be the safety valve up high. They have to yell him. He started to head right down.
2 minutes for checking from behind.
Usually teams will go with the 4-on-3 and a safety valve up high to stop balls from getting out loose rather than having five guys and crowding things down low. Israel gets the ball back. Bergman allowed to just walk in. Still managed to hit Ben Snyder with the shot, even though Snyder was pretty much out of his way. Culp has it. He'll slow it down a bit, pass it over. There's a shot by Hopper, knocked down by McBride. He does a great job tying up his man, and the ball is picked up by the Irish. Sean Gibson running the length of the floor, spins back away from Silberlicht. Excellent job. Still 54 seconds on the 5-on-3 for Israel. They can afford to double-team the ball, double-team one man off the ball. Flapen's going to slip in and pick up that ball after it pops away from Gibson, and Israel will head up the floor again on the 5-on-3. Culp takes it back from Bergman, crosses, passes across. Quick release, misses the net by Hopper. 6 seconds to shoot, and Culp gets a reset by banging it off of Cregan's pads. Clark gives it to Culp. Culp shoots, it goes off the stick of Snyder up into the mesh. It'll be Israel ball once again. Ball returns to the field, and they start up again. 10 seconds in the 5-on-3. Ireland could get some momentum if they can kill this off. Culp, a couple of fakes, flicks it back to Bergman. Hopper scores. Just
Israel.
As the penalty expires, we'll see whether it was on the first or the second. It was very close to the expiration of the first penalty. And Tyler Roach is stepping out of the box. Everyone leaving the box for Ireland. They're going to say it came after the first penalty expired. So that will wipe out the Ireland penalty. They almost managed to kill that 5-on-3. They do get through the first of them. But Israel cashes to make it 7-4. 2 minutes and 51 seconds into the third quarter.
Israel goal scored by number 11, Brian Hopper, assisted by number 43, Kyle Bergman. That's Bergman and Hopper.
McCormick, Campbell. Whistle goes. McCormick wins the faceoff, scoops it up.
Israel possession.
Gets run into by Keogh, but evades the check, puts his shoulder down, turns into a Tyler Roach coming the other way and just rolls the ball to Dan Deckelbaum. Israel setting up on the offense. 7-4 lead. Jason Crosby screaming for Chad Culp to pay attention. Culp gets the shot. Comes right back to him, shoots Cregan, another save. Scooped up. Snyder runs into a few Israeli players. Nice little shovel pass to Tyler Roach. Gets away from him, but Sonny Campbell picks it up. Hopper runs over Campbell. Roach goes to the net. Beautiful goal. No, it's a no goal. They're going to say he was in the crease. The ball may have gone in, but the shot hit Higgins. Then rolled down, and Roach's momentum carried him into the crease. Great little duck and drag, but can't quite finish. Israel still up 7-4. Bergman takes the pass way up at the top of the formation. Miller hanging on to it. 8 on the shot clock as Miller drives the net, spins back out. Deckelbaum's got it with 3 to shoot. He'll just let it fly wide up into the... just behind the Irish bench. May have gone out the open side of this building. I think somebody's chasing that ball around the parking lot as we speak.
Israel 7,
Gillis.
Ireland 5.
Trots over center. 7-5. Israel ahead with 10:40 to go here in the third quarter. Owens up top, gives it back to Keogh. Runs in over the restraining line. Steps around the pick from Owens. They fight through it and pick him up.
On the score.
Tries to get the roll. Owens flattened by Freed with some help from Flapan. 2 seconds to shoot. Kelly can't get it off. Nice check by Kevin Harper. Flapan will start things moving forward. Israel setting up. Still getting the offensive guys out. Zach Paul, the fourth, and now Chase Clark, the fifth offensive player. Paul slips one check, spins off another, gets grabbed, goes to the crease, and is flattened by Andrew McBride, who lifts his hands to show he's not doing anything and then cross-checks him as he gets up and walks away. Tyler Roach backing in. A little high, but it's nabbed by Tim O'Connor. Roach flips it ahead, gets by Gillis, but there's Kelly to catch it. Sorry, that's Witchman with it.
Ball.
The shot clock expires. Ball knocked loose. Scooped up by Miller. Andrew McBride is screaming that that's over and back. That's a pretty good case, but Israel maintains possession. Now Silberlicht is flattened, and it's going to be an Irish penalty. And another penalty coming. Or Israel gets the ball back, shoots, the shot clock expires. It goes in. They're saying a reset. And Andrew McBride's getting an unsportsmanlike conduct call. Shea takes an illegal body check call. And Andrew McBride, unsportsmanlike for vociferously voicing his opinion about the over back call. McBride still trying to ask why that wasn't over and back. Now the score clock, the confusion here is that the score clock is showing 6-5.
7-4.
It should be 7-4. We'll just check our records here. We've got all the goals written down. It should definitely be 7-4 for Israel. One goal has gone up on the wrong side. Chad Culp is appalled. It seems that so the score should be 7-4. We've got all the goals written down. Started with
4 minutes.
Israel with the only goal of this quarter. It was scored by Brian Hopper. We'll just run through. The first goal scored by Noah Miller for Israel. Ireland then gets two. One from Kevin Owens. One from Brian Gillis. Israel tied it up on a goal by Chad Culp. Ireland then went ahead on Keogh's goal. Israel then with four straight goals from Silberlicht, Hopper, Miller, and then Hopper again. Then Ireland got one back, Gillis scoring, and then the seventh goal for Israel, scored by Brian Hopper, the last one. What has happened? It appears that one has gone up for Ireland instead of Israel. A game operations person is coming down. Officials taking a timeout. 8:49 to go in the third quarter of what is becoming. So they're trying to figure this out. It looks like a goal has been put up for Ireland instead of Israel. And it's turning into an extended timeout for both teams. And they have, part of the question is that Ireland's goal was accredited to number 11, an Ireland goal, because it was Brian Hopper for Israel that scored it. They said number 11. The scorekeeper thought it was a goal for Ireland, heard 11, and now that has caused some confusion, but it made her realize. So the scorer is calling up to the game operations manager, saying it should be 7-4 to the clock operator. And they have corrected it on the scoreboard. Thanks, a nice round of applause from the Israeli players. Even the Irish fans are applauding that the score has been corrected. Quite a kerfuffle here. And now Sean Gibson having a chat. Their captain, Andy McBride, is in the box for his unsportsmanlike penalty call.
Ladies and gentlemen, after doing some sorting out, get some numbers together, it is, the correct score is Israel 7, Ireland 4.
So Chad called,
four.
And Kevin Owens having a little chat about things.
Let's go, Israel!
So we will get underway eventually with the score set in at 7-4. And now the scorekeeper is asking why 37 is in the box. And he glares at the official thinking, I'm wondering the same thing myself. Okay. So just a reminder, McBride. A little confusion about the numbers, too. They're saying 36. It's 56. Mike Shea has 2 minutes for an illegal body check. Andrew McBride, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike for arguing the over and back call. That shot by Bergman knocked butt down. The Irish almost killed a 5-on-3 a little while ago, but got into the final 20 seconds and gave up a goal. There's a shot, a hop by Hopper to try and catch the ball and shoot. But the Irish come up with it. They'll have a chance to kill some time here. Ben Snyder running the ball across the mid-floor mark. Chad Culp gets on the offside of it, and Flapen couldn't help him pin him. Now they're gonna try and double team him. Flapen gives him a push. Snyder evades, gets along the boards. Flapen has to be careful he doesn't get a slashing call with two calls going against the Irish in a row. Big check there by Silberlich, ramming him into the boards. The ball popped loose, Israel kept checking, so Ireland will get a fresh 30. That is a great call for the Irish. As Snyder earns that second possession, they'll be able to kill another 30. 109 left in the minors to Andrew McBride and Mike Shea.
Number 37, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike.
Israel not particularly aggressive in pressuring, and you can hear the coaches from the Irish bench saying, from the Israeli bench saying pressure. Leventhal is up there. Chad Culp is staying up in the offensive zone on the restraining line. Owens has the ball, so it's just 4-on-3 in the defensive zone. If Israel's able to get the ball, they'll have Culp wide open. Now Ireland gets a man off the bench, off the floor, so that Tyler Roach can go and pick up Culp. Harper runs the ball up the floor, steps over center. 30 seconds left in the penalties. 20 on the shot clock for Israel. Past the midway point of the third quarter. Noah Miller gets for a hard check from Roach up around the neck. Gets a shot off. 10 seconds left of the 5-on-3. Harper is staying back at midfloor as the safety valve. So Israel can probably go ahead and shoot. Bergman does take a shot, and Harper being there pays off just as the shot clock, as the penalties expire. Bergman to Hopper to Culp. The shot off the post. McBride, fresh out of the penalty box, picks up the ball. He'll run it up the floor. He's still pretty fired up. You can see the glare in his eyes on the veteran defenders as the veteran defender heads to the bench. Ireland will set up, killing the double minors. The 5-on-3 often can be a nice swing in motivation and momentum for a team. We'll see if Ireland can take advantage of it. Shot by Wichman just before the shot clock expires. comes out to Gillis. He takes a shot.
Israel.
Just at the shot clock expiration. 6:10 to go here in the third quarter. I'm Stephen Samperini, this WILC game. In the green division, Deckelbaum with the ball. Shot saved by the foot of Cregan.
Cregan with a save.
Ireland just about to pick up the ball, but Zach Paul gets on it. McBride picks it up. Sorry, and that's an over and back, and Ireland does call it.
Zone violation.
Or the officials do call it.
Israel ball.
Now we have a penalty coming. Too many men on Israel. That's a pretty easy one because they have six guys running down the floor, all heading into the offensive zone. Not much to wonder. There's no judgment call there. Andrew McBride is still over having a chat
Israel
with the official about the over and back call.
32, the in-home. Daniel Leventhal.
He's much calmer, but he's getting a little riled up as he walks off the floor and says, it cost us two penalties that you blew that call. That coming from McBride? My personal opinion? Yeah, probably was over and back. There's a shot to the far side by Keogh, saved by Higgins. Ireland on the power play trying to get back from this 7-4 deficit. Owens gets the ball back up top, passes it down low. Kelly with the fake goes to Gillis. Owens, sub shot scores.
Ireland
goes down just below sidearm and buries one off the leg of Higgins and inside the post. It's now 7-5, which was one of the scores that was up on the board for a while. Stephen Keogh, number 28, burying that shot. Or sorry, Kevin Owens, number 32. It was 32 from 88. Brian Gillis getting the assist. Seven-five, 5:10 to go here in the third quarter.
Ireland goal to number 32, Kevin Owens.
Cole McCormick comes up with another face-off win. Takes a bit of a check from
Gillis.
Mike Shea. Deckelbaum down low. Bergman's going to roll up top. Big check in behind the goal on the off man. Miller taking his time, 7 seconds to shoot. Deckelbaum bounces one, goes wide. Shea takes a wild swing at the ball, misses. Deckelbaum gets the ball, shot off of Cregan. Fresh 30 coming. Miller falls on top of the ball with a little help from some Irish hands. Sorry, Zach Paul does. Ben Snyder traps him and it's picked up by Andrew McBride as the ball pops out. Ireland has the ball and will head up the floor. McBride's just going to pass it off and head to the bench. Tyler Roach with a little spin. Deckelbaum and Freed watch him. He gets it over to Gillis. And Tim O'Connor gives it off to Stephen Keogh. Owens cuts to the net as they move the ball around the outside. Big pick from Roach. Shot a little bit wide. Keogh could have had that, but Gillis actually tried to climb it. Shot clock about to expire, so Keogh fires. Saved by Higgins. Roach goes after it. Roach knocks the ball. The ball is in the crease.
Violation.
Roach knocks
Israel
it out.
Ball.
Swings at the stick of Higgins, and Higgins wants a checking in the crease call. And we're taking a timeout. It is the official's timeout with 3:51 to go in the third quarter of a game that is becoming one of the longer games
in
World Indoor Lacrosse Championship history. A lot of things to sort out. But we are clear, it is 7-5 for Israel. 3:51 to go in the third quarter. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more of the WILC from the Onondaga Nation.
I can just play on the boss. tennis glove. I don't have that much status. I don't want to be at the airport that long anyway.
At least you're not doing crazy.
No, Chicago's not that long.
It's like an hour ahead.
It's 2 hours. It's 3 hours there, 2 hours back. But, you know, you run into a tight.
Israel moving the ball up the floor. 7-5 as we get back underway with the third quarter. Well, this Israel-Ireland game at the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships. Bergman rolls high, shoots off the post. Goes straight out to Noah Miller. He'll go back up to Bergman. Chulp with a spin off of Gibson. Passes it through. Great
Cregan
pass.
With a save.
But Bergman stopped by Cregan. He was all alone. A naked look on top of the crease. A great save by Cregan. Gibson will get the ball up the floor, and Ireland will try to creep ever closer. They're trailing 7-5. Ireland led 2-1. But then the Israelis really went a bit of a roll. Penalty coming.
Penalty coming up.
Illegal cross-checking call to Tim O'Connor. And they'll put Israel back on the power play.
Penalty to Ireland's number
Ireland's
five,
penalty Tim killers, O'Connor. Tyler Roach, Andrew McBride, Mike Shea, and Ben Snyder. Check. Israel's going to
That's number five. 2 minutes the power for illegal play. Body check.
And again, there's a delay as they, looks like the penalty clock once again did not start rolling when the game clock did. There's 3:01 left here in the third quarter. Miller and Hopper, the righties for Israel over on the far side. Deckelbaum and Bergman as usual. The lefties on the near side and Chad Culp is up top. Now the penalty clock reset to 2 minutes. Just have to reset to 3:03 for the game clock and all that for 2 seconds of game time. And we're back underway. Culp to Miller. Hopper goes back up to Miller. Culp on the crease to Bergman. Cregan turns him aside again. Bergman with a pair of glorious chances. McBride roughing him up. Gonna have a moving pick on Ireland as the Irish regained control of that ball pop loose, but Andrew McBride had a grip on Bergman down in the corner. Bounce him around, and the Israel will get a fresh 30 in possession of the ball once again. Just over a minute and a half to go in the penalty. 2:34 to go here in the third quarter. Hopper tries to spin off a check. McBride stays on him, runs him into the corner. Culp will hit Hopper again. He gets another rough ride for McBride and Owens. Sorry, McBride and Snyder. There's a cut to pass to Bergman.
Penalty
the stick gets
up
around his neck. The shot clock expires. We'll have another penalty coming to Ireland. A holding call. Going to the Irish captain. Andrew McBride. And he's removed his shoe in disgust at the call. He's going to have to untie that and get it put back on. He's got plenty of time. He'll sit for 2 minutes or less. But if there's a goal, it would release the O'Connor penalty first.
Penalty to Ireland, number 37.
And they score
Andrew
immediately.
McBride. Or holding.
Israel wasting no time.
Score Israel.
And O'Connor is released. Bergman, after a couple of glorious chances, manages to find one, get one to find its way to the back of the net. It's now 8-5 with 2:06 to go in the third quarter. McCormick and Campbell line up for the faceoff.
He does, like
like on occasion. I mean, that's where like the games usually hosted, right? But even though I thought it was good for
the Ireland gets the ball. Keogh, fake pass, shoulder into the defender, knocks him down, turns and takes a swing at Dan Deckelbaum. Keogh getting a little frustrated. There's a big whack from Shea, the plastic on plastic making a loud sound. Culp to Hopper, toe drag, Cregan makes the stop. To make the short outlet. Kind of handcuffed his man. Snyder with the ball. Ben Snyder running about after taking the pass from Connor Dockery. Deckelbaum with some cross checks on him. Snyder switches sides, starts to head back behind the net. Shot clock expires as he places the ball down.
30-second violation.
And Israel comes ahead. 1 minute to go in the penalty. 107 left in the third quarter here. 8-5 the score for Israel.
Last minute of play in the third period.
Culp over to Bergman, the last goal scorer. Deckelbaum shoots, saved by Cregan's foot. Up into the mesh.
Possession remains with Israel.
He shoots too much, given his inability to get open.
Yeah, it works in Boston.
Bender, yeah.
Culp takes the pass. Deckelbaum sets a pick for him as Culp rolls over. Miller's shot up high. Does hit the glass, but it gets up into the beams of this beautiful Onondaga Village Pavilion.
Call.
And Ireland will get possession. Ireland with 16 seconds to kill on the penalty. 27 seconds left in this third quarter. 8-5 for Israel. Keogh with a pick for Owens. They move to the far side. Trying to get it to Keogh. He catches it. Gets the shot off. Higgins with the save. Keogh somehow getting a shot away with three Israeli defenders all over him. Pass out. Penalty coming to Ireland. Israel's got 7 seconds to get a shot off.
Ireland
Higgins
returns
running
to full
to the bench.
Strength.
Then they realize there's no time for him to get there. Deckelbaum will try to shoot. A little late
at the end of the third
period. There
will
be an Irish penalty.
Israel 8, Ireland 5.
Just after the other one has expired. Roughing for Stephen Keogh. He'd been banging about up there pretty good, and he's going to go to the penalty box to serve 2 minutes for it.
Penalties to Ireland's number 28, Stephen Keogh. 2 minutes for roughing. That's Keogh, 2 minutes for roughing. Brad Cronin to the scorers table, please. Brad Cronin. Brad Cronin to the scorers table, please. Brad Cronin. the beginning of the fourth period.
Welcome back, lacrosse friends. We are ready to go with period four, the final quarter of regulation time of this Israel versus Ireland game. Israel ahead 8-5. And on the power play,
Israel possession.
After a penalty at the end of the period, roughing to Stephen Keough for Ireland. I'm Stephen Stamp, bringing you this World Indoor Lacrosse Championships matchup.
Team Israel
from the Onondaga
the
Village Pavilion. Bergman up to Deckelbaum. Culp. Miller's got some room. He goes down low to Hopper, who steps out and gets a shot. No, makes a pass. Yeah. Several fakes. And
score
Bergman
Israel.
Connects. His second goal in a row. Makes it 9-5.
Israel goal.
Just waiting to get
score
the penalty removed from the scoreboard.
Kyle Bergman,
it's off. We're back to 5-on-5 lacrosse.
And
McCormick.
Brian Hopper and number 41.
Little face-off.
Noah Miller.
For Israel. Against Jordan for Ireland. McCormick gets the ball.
Possession
wins his own
Ireland.
Face-off. Israel goes back to the offense, leading 9-5. 30 seconds into this fourth quarter. Hopper leaves it there for Culp. A little confusion with the timing again. Clock not starting. Clock now runs down a few seconds. Now it goes to 1:43. Another official comes over to try and get things sorted out. So the score 9-5 in favor of Israel. Again, if Israel wins, then a German win over Serbia in the following game today would make a three-way tie. Israel actually in pretty good shape in that situation because they lost by 1 to Germany, but they won by about 6 goals over Serbia. On the other hand, so Germany would have to win substantially over Serbia as well. Thank you. Very cool. And we're underway. 14:30 to go. We're 30 seconds into the fourth quarter. Israel leading 9-5. Zach Paul moves it over to Bergman. He gives it to Culp. Miller goes for a bit of a run. Now he makes a pass. Or cutting Bergman gets away from him. Chad Culp takes it off the board. 7 seconds to shoot. Roach out on him. Drives pass. Comes in, shoots. Saved by Cregan. Will be a fresh 30, though, for Israel.
Possession calls. Ball stays with Israel.
Zach Paul takes the long lobbed pass and gives it off to Miller. Culp gets it back. Bergman with his shoulder pad still sticking out of his jersey on the left side there. Shot off the shoulder of Cregan. Another fresh 30 and Culp will just go for a trot. Long possessions are the friend of the Irish right now. Tyler Roach picks off that ball. It's knocked loose by Zach Paul, but Roach picks it up again. Silberlich sprinting to try and get him. Hopper on him, and Roach
Higgins
misses the net. Gets knocked down and falls to the ground.
Possession call Israel.
It'll be Israeli possession. They'll make their way slowly up the floor. Silberlich stays out to play offense. As Deckelbaum rolls down the far side. Deckelbaum still carrying the ball, 10 seconds. The Israelis going deep into every possession before they start thinking about going towards the net. Harper just kind of let a shot fly with a couple seconds on the shot clock. It misses by quite a bit and the shot clock expires. Ireland will try and eat into this 4-goal deficit. Wichman to Gillis. Kelly gets it to the far side to Owens. Gillis down to Kelly, gets it back. Score! No goal! It's underneath Zach Higgins.
No goal.
The Irish were hoping, thinking at least hoping, and it's going to be too many men on Israel.
What is that?
And Israel, coaches complain a bit. As the official runs by, he says, so early. Making it clear how he felt about that. So Zach Paul will go into the box to serve 2 minutes or less with 12:20 remaining in the fourth quarter.
For too many men served by the in-home number 32, Daniel
Gillis.
He's
going to pass the ball to Stephen Keel once play's blown in. Does so. Kevin Owens comes over to chat and gets the ball. They go down low to O'Connor. Wichman set up down on the crease. Keogh's backing away. Gillis shoots between the legs of Higgins, but he falls
Higgins
on it once again.
Save.
Very similar to the last play, and again, Higgins able to keep it out. Silberlicht. And the clock has stopped again. So we'll have a bit of a pause. The clock just stopped on its own as it was. Oh, no, they've stopped the clock. And the timers are saying that 71, Zach Paul, is in the box, but that the actual in-home player for Israel is Daniel Leventhal. So Leventhal getting ready to hop over the bench and go serve the penalty. He's got 1 foot up on the bench, 1 hand on the dasher of the boards, and is ready to jump over if necessary. Zach Paul has asked if the officials want him to switch. He's ready to go. Daniel Leventhal ready to hop in. All the officials chatting. Now Zach Paul released from the box. And he's calling for Leventhal to go.
A change of players. The in-home designated
Brad MacArthur actually smiling at the referees.
The situation is number 32, Daniel Leventhal.
And we will get underway with 12:03 to go here in the fourth quarter. Israel up 9-5. Now Andrew McBride having a chat with the officials. Now, Andy McBride is pointing out, saying to the official, that's another penalty if they sent the wrong player to the box. they share a bit of a grin.
I don't think it's cool. It's just nice to get the hair out of my eyes.
The penalty box door is closing. Nope. The official is going to have a chat. The referee's still talking. Indicate to each other that the ball is over on the far side. Bergman gets it. Play is blown in. And the clock starts at 12:03 and starts ticking down. Deckelbaum is just up outside the restraining line, killing time for the Israelis with their penalty. Now being served by Leventhal. What a shot
Score
by
Israel.
Daniel. Deckelbaum on the run, little hop shot, and just buries it. Top corner. Deckelbaum, his first
Israel
of the game.
Roll to number 23, Daniel Deckelbaum, unassisted.
So we go back to the faceoff dot, and it's now a 10-5 lead for Israel with the shorthanded goal from Deckelbaum. McCormick wins the faceoff, and they'll be able to kill some more time. Dockery comes running into the play, but they see him, so no big hit avails. Ireland not putting too much pressure with the extra man out there. You can hear some of the Irish players yelling, you gotta go get it. They want their teammates to go in pressure. Shot off the back boards. Jordan picks it up, heading down the other way. Ireland going on to the power play with Gillis with the ball. Flapen coming up behind him. Now he'll cross-check Keogh. There's a shot from the shooter spot. No touch, so it goes off the backboards out into the Irish bench. It'll be Israeli possession.
Israel.
29 seconds on the penalty, so they can kill the rest on this possession. Kill the rest of the penalty, the too many men call. Harper keeping his eyes peeled, tries to make the pass across. It gets by Snyder. It almost cost him. Harper caught it, but he missed. Culp on Snyder. He knocks it loose. Still loose. Finally, Cregan clamps down on the ball. Penalty expires. We're back to 5-on-5 lacrosse. Moving across the top is Owens. That one looked like it went off something loud, some loud part of Higgins' equipment. 3-8 Israel players running up the floor. Harper will slow it down,
full strength.
Let the offense get out there with a 10-5 lead and less than 10 minutes to play now in the fourth quarter. No hurry for Israel. Noah Miller starts to go to the bench, runs back down, just kind of flips a little backhander towards the net, right in the general vicinity of the net as the shot clock is about to expire.
Ireland
another
ball.
30 seconds gone for the Israelis. Ireland will set up an offense. Stephen Keogh with the ball. Goes over to Gillis. Higgins with the save on the shot from Keogh outside. He's lost his stick, but Keogh gets it back. Now it's picked up by Ireland again. Tyler Roach gets it. Gillis. Looking through traffic, nowhere for him to shoot. Tyler Roach knocked down. And Israel comes up with the ball. Dan Deckelbaum will pass it over to the far side. Now a pass to a cutting Adam Crystal. He's going to the net. Shoots, psych save by Cregan. Silberlich kind of jogs over to the loose ball, so Tyler Roach hammers him into the boards. And then Mike Shea really hammers him into the boards. Roach tries to pick the ball up. Zach Paul knocks it away. Sibelik returns the hit. Gets his stick up into the grill of Tom O'Connor. So O'Connor gets a shot back to Sibelik. He's going to stay back and play defense. Roach is just taking a penalty for running over Sibelik. Saved by Ireland. Israel will take their time. They've got Higgins off to the bench and almost a full 30 to use as a 6-on-5 with the extra attacker. Culp to the back door. Miller shot low. Saved by Cregan, and Ireland comes up with it. It's going to be an illegal cross-check call to Tyler Roach. Another two-minute power play for the Israelis. They'll see if they can take advantage of the man, extra man. They already leave 10-5.
Ireland penalty. To number
we take
20,
the media
Tyler
timeout
Roach,
as we're under the 8-minute mark of the fourth check. Quarter. Tyler Roach will serve 2 minutes or less. There's 7:54 to go. Israel up 10-5. We'll take a quick break and come back with World Indoor Lacrosse Championship coverage. I'm Stephen Stamp with the call. We'll see you in a sec. We'll get back underway with Israel going to the power play. Chad Culp is up high, having a nice friendly chat with the official.
In the fourth period.
The two-minute penalty for illegal cross-checking to Tyler Roach as Israel leads 10-5, and we'll try to extend that lead. There's a shot goes over the top by Paul. Culp will give it back to Paul, let him try again. He ducks down, passes instead to Hopper. His shot is stopped. And he's in the crease as he reaches for it after.
Crease violation.
Ireland gets the ball.
It's not there, it's not there.
It's going to be a moving pick. Gillis hadn't got the ball yet, and Cole McCormick just ran him right into the board. So Ireland will get possession and a chance to kill 30 seconds of this penalty. Gillis quick stepping his way around. McCormick goes to the net. Pushed by Lundy, lands in the crease, turnover, Israel gets the possession. Brad MacArthur just yelling slow to his team. There's no rush for this club as they lead 10-5. 7 minutes now left in the fourth quarter of this game. Israel, of course, if they get this, they're up by five, and they did win by about 6 goals against Serbia. That shot by Paul off the post, they get a fresh 30. So they're going to have a very positive differential in their plus minus, goals for and goals against. Germany beat Israel by one. Lost by three to Ireland. Zach Paul gets his goal. Had a try earlier, passed off another chance. Now he shoots into the corner. And it's 11-5 for Israel. Israel on a 9-2 scoring streak here. Since
Israel
Ireland actually did lead 3-2 at one point.
Zachary Paul.
Since then it's been 9-2 for Israel.
The captain Chad Culp. And number 23, Daniel Deckelbaum.
Sean Gibson out to take the faceoff for Ireland. Can't draw, get the draw. So Israel will set up. Culp passes it over. No, he doesn't pass it to Lundy. Lundy will now go off to the bench. And Israel gets another attacker out. Culp tries to cut to the net. Chase Clark tries to drive down low. He's turned aside by Shea. Miller running around, throws it back, and a penalty coming. Chase Clark with the illegal cross-checking call. He'll get on the scoreboard.
Penalty to
Ireland.
Number 91,
has the ball on
Chase
the power
Clark.
Play.
2 minutes for cross checking. Illegal cross check. 2 minutes.
Gillis to Keogh. Keogh shoots. Foot save by Higgins. Pounces on the rebound. Juggles it a bit, but now makes the pass up to Flapen. Flapen steps over center with a couple seconds to spare. Spins off a check from Keogh. Will run along the boards. Turns back up. Switches hands and goes over to Deckelbaum, then heads for the bench. Keogh trying to push him over center. Deckelbaum, swim move, heads down towards the net. 7 seconds to shoot. Israeli coaches calling their offensive players over to the bench so they can get their defenders out. Deckelbaum eventually flips it up in the air,
violation.
Down
Ireland
towards
ball.
The corner. Now Ireland comes up onto the offense on the power play. Shea will give it off to Gillis. Gillis gets it back from Owens, returns it. Quick stick in front by Roach. That one's turned aside by Higgins. Pass picked off by Dalton Lundy. He'll step out of the crease. 3 Israel players just kind of standing still. So Lundy runs the ball up. Gets across before the 10-second count. Shot by Culp, bounces off the boards and goes to Owens. Owens will head up and join the offense. Just 20 seconds left on the power play, but the Irish still with some time to do something. Owens will just let it rip. Nice pickup by Wichman. Gets it back to Owens, and Gillis now will shoot. That one goes wide as well. 14 seconds on the shot clock. It's McCormick with the check. I'm going to say McCormick was on the back after the ball got loose, so it's going to be a possession call going to Ireland. Roach is knocked down by Flapen. That pass gets away from McCormick. He's going to track it down and get checked by Dockery. Dockery knocks the ball loose, and Gibson heads up into the offensive zone. Sorry, that was Zach Jordan knocked that ball free. Keogh takes the pass. Kelly to Roach. On the far side, Keogh makes the hard pass across, but it's low and hits a defender in the hip. Looked like Silberlicht was going to be gone. Now it's Harper instead, breaking away off the post.
Reagan with a
picked
save.
Up by McBride, lobs it ahead. Shea will go the other way. 3:18 to go in the fourth quarter. An 11-5 lead for Israel. Shea with the shot a little bit wide. Bounces up into the mesh.
Out of bounds, possession call, Israel.
Flapen taking his time moving forward. 3 or 4 possessions by Israel and the game will be over. They can just keep Ireland from running up 6 goals in the time that they have the ball. McBride on Culp. Israel just trying to kill this time. Swim move by Culp, 6 seconds to shoot. Goes to the net, dives off the far post, bounces off of Cregan. Culp almost had himself a goal. Instead, Ireland will get the ball back. There's Gillis cutting, shoots just wide on the far side. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Roach. O'Connor passes out and Wichman passes
Ireland.
Out. And Tyler Roach has connected for Ireland. Assist to Wichman. 11-6.
Goal to number
207
20,
to play.
Tyler Roach assisted by number 2, Drew Wichman. That's Roach and Wichman.
Sonny Campbell back in the faceoff dot for Ireland while Cole McCormick continues to take the draws for Israel. Deckelbaum driving towards the net, spins back out. They're just going to try and kill time here. finish this game off. Deckelbaum to Culp. 10 seconds left. Irish players encouraging their teammates to go get the ball. Instead, they leave an opening. Chad Culp runs down into it. Scores Israel's 12th goal. .138 to play as Culp gets another goal. Ireland asking for a stick check.
To number 19, the captain, Chad Culp, assisted.
Adam Crystal, they'll check Adam
Daniel
Crystal's
Deckelbaum.
Stick. They'll put a ball in the stick, in the pocket. You're going to measure the length. Checking the pocket depth. Pocket width. And the ball rolls out satisfactorily. Stephen Keogh goes over to check. Somewhat ironic since Keogh has one of the deepest pockets of any player I've ever seen.
We have an equipment check.
So it will be a penalty.
Penalty coming up.
For illegal equipment to Adam Crystal. The stick will be confiscated until after the game. And they pass the stick through as Crystal has to have a stick to serve the penalty. Brad MacArthur indicator is about a half an inch out of measurement. So that'll be a penalty to Crystal. It'll be a power play for Ireland, who trail 12-6 with 1:38 to go. If you're wondering why Ireland would call for a measurement here, it's because they are losing by 6 goals. They're not expecting to win this game, but goals
Israel
for and against critical in the determining of who will advance
Crystal
to the next round. So Ireland trying to get an advantage to try and get an extra goal or two. Andrew McBride. There's going to be a face-off at mid-floor. McCormick and Owens to face off. McCormick tries to kick it out with his foot, but Andrew McBride gets there first.
Ireland possession.
Gillis passes it off. Owens shoots, saved by Higgins. Israel running the ball up the floor. Snyder trying to stop Harper, but he gets across midfloor now. Roach trying to tie him up. Harper gives it off and goes to the bench for a rest. Flapen will pass over to Lundy. Israel killing time here. Culp has the ball.
Last minute of play in the fourth period.
He gets checked, the ball's loose. Culp goes to the floor, just stays on top of the ball using his feet. Tyler Roach gets it as the shot clock expires. Culp with some words for the ref. Ireland goes forward. They're going to set up on the power play with 44 seconds to play in this game. Gillis, shot by Shea. Bounces off of Higgins.
With the save.
Flapen tries to throw a big check. Just hits the boards.
Possession call.
It's going to be Israeli ball. Flapen Israel. Has it. Stephen Keogh hacking at him, and Keogh's going to get a penalty. Keogh, a little fake towards Flapen. He gets an unsportsmanlike conduct call for it. So Keogh will get 4 minutes. Dead ball foul for the initial penalty. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. So 4 minutes will go up. And we'll be back to 4-on-4 for the final 32.6 seconds.
Double penalty to Ireland's number 28, Stephen
Chad
Steele.
Copel start with the ball up top. We're 4-on-4.
Dead ball foul. And 2 minutes.
Roach comes up to pressure a bit. Not too much pressure from the Irish. Deckelbaum has the ball. 25 seconds to go. 21 on the shot clock. About a 2 second difference. Culp runs in to Ben Snyder. They're jousting a bit with their sticks. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Hopper to Deckelbaum. Culp has it. 2 seconds left. He's just going to drop it in the corner. And time continues to wind. The game ends.
That's the end of the fourth.
Israel has triumphed 12-6 over Ireland. Israel and Ireland both now 2-1 in the tournament in the round robin stage. So Germany, if they can win, will create a three-way tie, and then it'll go to goal differential to see who gets in. And Serbia would be 0-3 and would be out. If Serbia beats Germany, then Serbia and Germany are both out, and Ireland and Israel both go on to the next round. That will do it for us here from the beautiful Onondaga Nation Pavilion, Village Pavilion. I'm Stephen Stamp for the World Indoor Lacrosse Championships. Thanks for being with us, lacrosse friends. We'll see you next time.
Ireland and Israel. Fine job, gentlemen. And to the coaching staff, Tony Reed, Christian Getzky, Keith Gagne, and Eddie Shenandoah.